Hey, what's good, everyone? It's me, Bishanye, here for another episode of some D&D painting. Thanks for joining, blah, blah, blah. We're going to be doing some of our NPCs like we've been doing before, except this time, instead of getting to draw fun and friendly people of Faerun, we're going to be drawing some more monsters. We've already done the kobolds and their archetypes, but today we're going to start on the goblins. And there's actually going to be a couple of different types that we're going to cover today, and I'm going to come up with some symbols, or rather some items, to help you kind of visualize what's going on. One thing I can say is that there are going to be three types. We're going to cover actual small, you know, under 4 foot goblinoids, that kind of tribe mentality, and then we're also going to cover some of the goblin derivatives, like the bugbear. We're going to have three archetypes of them. And then we're going to have two archetypes of the Hobgoblin. Ooh. And we're going to name them and all that shit too, probably. But I think it'd at least be a good start to get to drawing some of their faces. So I've got a board on an easel here. And I've got a piece of white paper that I'd previously set up ready to go. And other than that, I just need a marker. There's no pencil on this. I haven't started with anything. And, well, that's because that's how I like to do it. And I'm going to show you how to do it too. I figured this was kind of a little bit more of a Bob Ross kind of setup, so where you can actually see what I'm doing while seeing my face. I hope it works out for you too. I got some Gatorade and I got some 80s tunes bumping. Down at the bottom of the marquee, you're going to see plenty of addresses where you can go and find me. I encourage you to listen along with Spotify. If you go on my channel and scroll down, you can see the now playing. I'm going to start off in 80s jams, but I don't know where I'm going to wander right now. I'm getting some Armageddon by Def Leppard, which is my favorite song off of their album Hysteria. And don't forget, if you want to donate, hit me up on either Twitch. We have a donation page through Stream Elements or through our Patreon, and that's patreon.com/ruinsofadventure. Let's draw some goddamn goblins, shall we? See, I just got a Facebook message. From another local designer here in the Ville. Oof, that's a long message. Oh man, I'll have to read that one in a second. Let's take a picture and say hi. I'll throw a disco ball in. I don't know what the fuck that does. And I'll flip the camera around. God damn, man. Facebook got complicated. That's all I'm saying. Find a face. There we go. Hey! With a Sharpie. And the whole thing. Oh, shit. Did I lose my face? We got the setup going. We live. That'll have to work for me. God damn it. I def want to read that dope message. But I'm live. There's a shout out. Okay. Moving right along. Get our goblins. So we're gonna work left to right. I'm gonna go goblin, bugbear, hobgoblin. When I first start to do these faces, I want to remember to just work in shapes, but more often than not, I'll steer away from like a hard pose in lieu of starting with the detail that I can get right. What we know about goblins, no matter what mythos you're thinking, they are short. They do have these really elongated ears. Typically full of piercings and really elongated noses, specifically this, the bridge of theirs is pretty long, so it can be tempting to want to draw them in profile, but I would say just draw them head on, or sometimes at a three quarter. I think I'm probably going to go three quarter. Have everybody facing this way, most likely. Or they could both be facing the inner. That'll actually probably work a little bit more, so since the first guys I'm going to draw are going to be shorter than the rest. I've really got to show that. Thinking a semicircle. Yeah, bring that first ear kind of in. I'm going to get under that with something really long. I'm imagining a gauge piercing right there. Some piece of bone right there to kind of note the skull. So it kind of comes forward to that heavy brow. I'm going to furrow that brow right there, bring it out on the other side. Let's bring that nose down and back. Yeah, we're going to need to get that other ear, so bring that other semicircle, or bring another semicircle kind of up to the back, make these lines. And what I'm seeing along this one are some piercings, so I'm going to put some rings just like that, and then I'm going to bring that line right through, kind of show the distorted area of the piercings. I'm going to bring that first fold of that ear, you know, this one right here, I'm going to bring that one down and in. I'm going to bring out that second, and then this cavity right there will actually serve as the canal. All full of piercings, and we'll put another piercing over here, maybe some sort of, you know, deviated piercing with just like a spike. I do not feel like Kokomo from the Beach Boys. Not really feeling Holland notes either. Some heart. I think I can handle that probably. So let's bring this nostril down. Let's put another piercing here through the nose. Let's get the bottom part of that eye going. Should be having a cheekbone about right there, and then just draw that down and out. Since we're doing this three-quarter, we're probably going to see a chin around here. So we can bring this jawline down. Start to bring it forward. Get that line down. We're going to see just a little bit of the eye over there. And then for this actual bottom portion of the mouth, they have pretty wide mouths. So bring that up through. And that lip just like that. As the face connects down. That hard pointed chin. Yeah, just like that. Kind of distorted, gargoyle-like, I would say. Never. That's a little too intense, I gotta say. Got a couple of viewers. Say howdy. Throw me a chat. Hello. We drawn some goblins. We got a hit of one. No. Everyone can be so shy. Okay. Let me check. You can kind of see where I'm going on this head. Pardon me. Okay, so I can hear that black velvet has come on. I'll oddly enough be okay with this one. So let's get to the body. Like I said, we're going to do archetypes, so we'll fit his and above his head here. So let's come down with this neck into a body. Now, the book does provide that Durbuluk in Goblin means dominator. So you're dealing with a pretty harsh, and I'm going to add a brow furrow here. It kind of comes back. You're dealing with kind of a deranged, well, I guess it'd be a deranged to people who weren't, like, totally down, just, like, fuck you up, but definitely a little more on the deranged side of just militarized, formed, hardened, dedicated more than anything in the reconquest of goblin territory. So we're actually, you know, going to probably want to add in some sort of feature to them to let people know that there's something different. So I'll probably use colors to notate that with some sort of like face paint or something like that, but I definitely want to make sure that they have a very specific looking armor, and what appeals to me is a scalp armor. So kind of do some of these patches with just little tufts of hair, and I'm going to draw the hair kind of like this, We'll have that old style stitching, you know, as it kind of goes between. We're doing hair on every piece, you know, it'll come off kind of like that. Not every piece is hair. Bring it across the chest here. Oof, man. It's crazy style of armor, isn't it? Made out of scalps. I like it. Let's get another one kind of in here. You know, maybe some stitching. We're going to carry that just right below this area as well. And now let's throw some textural in here. Let's say maybe some bones make up the middle, and they're pretty short torsoed. So just bring those bones kind of around. And at this point, we'd already be to the legs. So our decision at this point, artistically, kind of just involves forming a vignette of the rest of their armor and doing your best to describe what they're using and carrying. So I'm going to put an arm out here, bring that kind of like across, and I'm probably going to put some in his hand. I'm going to do the same back here. If you had one arm up, it'd be really difficult to have both arms up, so the other one's probably going to sink down. Get to about right there, up. And that forearm probably extends down. The choice now is, what do we want to show in their hands? Well, if I'm thinking Dominator, I'm not really thinking of a kill first kind of operation. I see something a little more to the tune of like capture. So in this arm, I'm gonna put a raised hand that's coming up to like a fist here. And I'm gonna bring, how do you actually use those? I think one, when you throw a bola, is it, minute work. Do you swing both of the balls or do you just swing one? I think you swing both because they kind of do that motion. So I'm gonna put, you know, some sort of like snare piece down here. Well, I'm gonna put one going out this way and one going out this way. And instead of just regular bola balls, I'm gonna have them be spiked. So I'm gonna throw a spike here, spike there, spike there, and then kind of draw a circle and make sure there's one right there. Just kind of, you know, note that they are spiked. We'll do the same back here. This one will be a little bit smaller. Put a spike there, spike there, spike there, spike there, spike there. You're going to put two lines on either side of them, and then you're going to draw some motion marks like this. A couple more to let people know that they're being swung. I guess this particular goblin is left-handed. And then down here, you know, he'd probably have some sort of bracer on both hands. And then likely some sort of arm covering. And I'm going to go chain. So I'm going to get a pattern of just circles going. Kind of looks like scales. And then I see these bracers being some sort of like wrapped cord. Let's get a lot of volume in those lines. Yeah. What's in the other hand, pray tell? Well, I see a net, but more importantly, I'm trying to think of what you would need to stop someone from attacking you. So I actually see some sort of more like, I don't know, hammer? That would mean to like stop you. So I guess I'm actually seeing a war pick. So let's pretend that maybe these these right hands, there's like some sort of glove that's on, reaching down kind of into that fist again, bringing that hand forward, and then it comes out at the top right there. Carry that forward just a little bit, and then this portion we're gonna bring it back into that pick shape. We're gonna bring it forward and kind of make it look a little bit 3D by giving it that two line treatment. We're gonna bring it up into this flat surface. Alright, boom. And then kind of hanging down here. And let's give a, you know, maybe a corded wrapping up there around his fist. And then let's put some lines on it. So he's got that war pick and he's got that bola. And he's probably very quick. And he'll have this pain on his face. Yeah. Let's put him in a power stance. So we'll kind of put the crotch here. And we'll put the legs going out to either side. And those will be kind of less important. I wouldn't see a loincloth in this instance. I would see some sort of cannon. I mean, you wouldn't want, you know, infantry of this level just going in with nothing. So I'm putting some kind of stripes on in there. And now we need to determine the archetypes. So if one's got a bola and a war pick, then I also see one that's got a net. So I'm just going to put their name really quick. This is a goblin. Voila. So the typical archetype I'm going to have with this bola and war pick. And then I'm going to make a couple of alternates. But I need to think of what his title, you know, could possibly be. But I also think I'm going to do that. So let's just detail the other weapons. So let's do the net. How I'm going to do the net is rather than showing it just kind of like flying at them, I'm going to do a bunch right here. I'm going to repeat that line a few times and then do kind of like a corded cinch to hang it off. And then I'm going to take it on a couple of different spreads because those kinds of nets are attached to weights. So I'm going to get to here and then fuzz it and then add kind of like rounded stone. And then I'm going to attach them each with a reinforced line. I'm going to bring another fold in here because this one is kind of tucked back up in there, if you can kind of see that. And then in order to get the rest of the feel across that this is a net, I'm going to crosshatch it. So bring these lines across, then bring them back. Yeah, just like that. We'll do the same down here. And then bring them back. Yeah, just like that. So we got the net. And I'm going to color in these stones down here and just leave a little bit untouched. Okay, so there's also the net. And what other archetype do we want to see? Well, I think seeing some sort of like ultra melee build would be pretty cool rather than just these trappers and instigators. Or rather, maybe some sort of range. I could dig that. So what would be a good range for them? I see maybe kind of like this like knife throwing archetype. But I think maybe it should be more like a blow dart gunner. Could you get poisons like that up here? What are they going to give me on this playlist? I'll take Peter Cetera, if nothing else. So yeah, this range build that I'm thinking of. I don't want to jump for Grenadier. Trying to think of what they could have that they could give to them to make it worthwhile. Maybe some sort of magical blessing. Oh, actually, I was thinking about this. I was wanting to weaponize the hot curry plate from Super Smash Brothers. So that's what I'll do. One of them will openly take damage by eating this thing that makes them spew fire. So how do I want to... I guess I'll probably just draw a flame or some like jet. It kind of goes out looking a little bit like yoga flame. Just kind of bring a couple of... Yeah. Kind of right like that. And then just bring that up into a fine point with maybe some kind of globs and splatter. And we can animate all that a little bit more clearly with the color once we get there. Okay, so we've got our goblin. Now we need to move on to our bugbear and then our hobgoblin. You can kind of see how much space we've got left, so... Kind of with what I was saying, the bugbear is going to be, you know, here facing everyone dead on. They kind of look primate-ish. So, I'm going to do the archetype that's going to be most prevalent. And I see them as like these shield movers that set up these tower shields. It kind of allow people to go forward, but instead of just regular tower shields, I see more like a war sled. So I'm going to kind of do the war sled a little bit. Or are they the war sled? Maybe they have some sort of blessing. Nah, I think they should operate one. So... Put his. He'll probably have a helmet on, so we'll bring this helmet down. Down to right here, get this face part. Yeah, just like that. And it would come wide. They'd have to cut it open to allow his goblin ears out, and we'll kind of do them a little more distorted. Yeah, to that side, and then bring this helmet up and in. You'd have the eye-opening part coming forward to the gate right there. And then finally up into kind of point. You know, this would be a bit of a rounded top. You know, another folded ear off into the side back there. Yeah, I'm going to add a little more value into some of these areas to kind of help draw the depth, which should have been done when I was first going through. Yeah, perfect, just like that. I'm going to bring that up. We're just getting these accents in. I'm going to bring that down and around. And, you know, you want to make these adjustments as you see them. You don't have to commit to doing a perfect drawing from the start. It will come together if you kind of follow these practices. Same with over here. Let's give the war pick, you know, an added bump of contrast there on that bottom side. Bring it across. Yeah, just like that. Okay. So we got our goblin kind of a little more fleshed out there. Going back to this bugbear. Bringing that kind of down. So how does he get this this part off? Well, it essentially means that this area has to be its own piece that's hinged.
Are you home?
Yep. Alright. We got a visitor on stream today.
What are you drawing?
We We got Vendrassi. We got our goblins finally going.
Nice. Hi, everybody.
They can't see you, but...
Oh, yeah. Hi, everybody. I like your place.
Good talk. Feel free to clear out some cap space and join.
I'm just, like, looking around real quick.
Okay.
Nice, you can just see my mouth.
There we go. Not really seeing a lot of that top part of the mouth. But then, let's get into this, bugbear's helmet.
Hey, Billy, do you know what the plural of goblins is?
Who's Billy?
B, do you know what the plural of goblins is?
Nope.
Moblin, a moblin of goblins.
And now we know.
Alright, come look at my fun room.
Alright, so we've kind of got their face. It'll be a little hidden, but that's all fine. We kind of got their ear kind of coming out there. So that'll all come up off their actual face. And if that's the case, then we actually wouldn't see anything but a leather strap right there. So this means this is their actual face. So I'm going to kind of fill in the beard a little bit. They're pretty hairy. Again, we're going to vignette off of their body, into this goblin feature, and we'll probably add the additional stuff. So them as a standalone unit, we'll have this helmet on. They're a little bulky to throw a cuirass on. Could we do it? We could... actually do something totally different. Let's bring a couple of burlap cords down here and let's anchor them in and let's do a stove plate. So it'll kind of come off over here and then bevel really hard and it'll just be kind of straight and comically unfitting. But they'll have multiple holes punctured for these corded knots to go and secure it. Same with up here. Bring these cords up. And now let's finish the actual stove plate. Bring it across. Don't forget these. And bring that up. Bring these shoulders out. You know, they're muscular. They're also kind of thick. These arms are going to be more muscled than anything else. Here, Hall & Oates. There's been some weird music being played. I guess I'm just not really feeling that particular genre anymore. Let's see what does sound good. I don't know what's in rap right now, but I know I added some stuff recently. That's rap with a question mark. Rap? I can always go for some Star Wars style shit, so... and he'll probably have an actual wrap on as well, so do some kind of like braided cords intermittently to just kind of offer a general protection. And then where we would have added some other things around, we'll have to save that space for offering the different abilities. And then let's go ahead and get his title up there. B-U-G-B-E-A-R, Bugbear. And we're going to just kind of draw some roundness to this, but in order to show it's a stove plate, we will need to do that kind of like circle in the middle. That would be mechanically kind of locked, if you will, by like a cog. So I'm going to do another circle, cut that off with a smaller circle, and then add it in and kind of bring it up off. Now we're going to add in our vents. just like that, because you'd be able to turn it. And I'm going to draw some lines up and off.
Did you check the mail today?
Nope.
Cool. I think I have a package from Amazon.
Congratulations.
I think I have a package, Booster.
Okay, so we've got that stove plate on top of his chest. And, nobody's on chat currently. We do have some viewers. Feel free to chat. Oh, come back.
There we go.
Yeah. This is me. This is the Bob Ross setup.
Nice.
People, two complaints have happened. Number one, and we don't have to listen to music. I can actually put on like a TV program or something.
Whatever you feel more comfortable with.
I was starting to watch Sirens of the Realms earlier, episode one, if you wanted to do that.
I have no idea what that is, actually.
All right, that sounds like a winner. So I'm going to be going over to YouTube. I'll go ahead and post the link.
Put them to the
ringer
tonight and
goes. And I'll Okay, so history. A bunch of bullshit because I was in this. Have you checked up that Dua Lipa remix I had posted?
I don't think so.
I've been watching some pretty cool shit. Oh, let's start off with this Mario Vitale thing. That's cool.
Is that the Hot Wings?
Yeah, I haven't finished that episode.
I love that episode. Mario Vitale is amazing.
It's so new.
I think they came out with a new one.
So here's some army propaganda, where, in case you didn't know, the military is really cool.
Appreciation for vivid imagination with no boundaries.
So, to kind of bring everyone up, I'm watching Hot Ones. Which is a Before We Feast topic, and this episode has Mario Vitale on it. I'm going to post a link. Watch with us here. I'm still working on getting my YouTube plugin supported and up. I don't know how in the hell that just happened.
Eggs on East.
Okay. Whoops. That was pretty convoluted. I definitely didn't post the right thing. I don't know why it didn't copy. Let's try that again. Watch with us here. Okay. There we go. Just pull that open. I'll give you a couple of... There's a wisp.
Hey, wisp.
To recap names in the room for everyone, I'm Bashanye. That's Vindrasi. We have the wisp and Chuth.
Oh,
it's okay. It matters a lot less on this stream. Yeah. The other stream has like six times as many views.
Simon, I don't know how to
that was just that. Regular on the table, and I was hoping someone would come claim it, so it's nice to see that it's a wisp.
I mean, chances are
but yeah, players have a hard time calling me anything, but I'm switching up the seating to where I'll be facing you guys at home, to where all of the attention and focus will be pretty significantly skewed from being focused on me to focused on you, because I won't be looking at them. I'll be looking at you. And so everyone will have to look where I'm looking.
Paint some happy little goblins.
Yeah, we are painting some happy little goblins. So let me get this Mario Vitale going. Hopefully you've had time to open that link. Let me know if you have any problems.
Mario Vitale, what a man.
So they've already gotten through the first two sauces. I'm picking up
He's not wearing his Crocs anymore. 3 minutes
and 50 seconds. So I'll actually give you another minute. Crocs. Another minute 50. He did change from Crocs. He's wearing Yeezys now.
Yeah.
This is the worst news I've heard today.
It's not the worst news ever. I fucking hate Crocs.
No!
I think Kanye West even said in love with him. Isn't that what he said?
I don't give a fuck who said. I didn't get that far. I just started to learn about that. And he made him do the what's real, what's not
kind of
test.
Look at this basket I got today, Billy.
B. Jesus Christ. One more time.
Tabernacle.
Bashanye. Vindrasi. The Wisp. And Chuth. I don't know who this Billy character is.
Chuth!
I've got some good sniffs on me.
Oh,
He smells the dog at my house.
So we know that one of these alternate weapons we want for him is that war sled. So how do we show that war sled? I'm just going to draw it. What I ultimately see is kind of the front of a train. So I'm going to draw a triangle. I'm going to bring it forward. and then I'm going to put it down, and I'm going to kind of draw a parallel line to them. And then I'm going to bring this up at a pretty steep angle, and I'm going to bring that wide. I have more chairs.
No, I don't want a chair. I'm piecing. I need to be close okay. to my work.
And so if we have this portion right here, we have to say, well, what's so damning about that? Well, let's put some spikes on it. Let's put some front-facing spikes. And then up here, let's put something similar to barbed wire. To get that kind of effect, just draw an X. You know, we don't really know what it is, but we know that it's sticky and it's dangerous. And for most people, that's good enough. That's
kill.
Good enough.
Good enough to kill.
We're going to do another one right over here. Connect that. And make sure these are, you know, mostly all front facing. Some of these can kind of stick a little more out to the side. And it's okay if they're really asymmetrical, like they weren't put in with a lot of purpose. That kind of helps build a little more realism.
You want to start the video?
I was giving them another 2 minutes because I'm 3:50 in.
Oh. I didn't know this.
Somewhere between the Billies, that information got lost. All right, so we've got our war sled here. And what are they used to push it? And since I'll have the helmet on, I don't really have to worry about up. And they'll probably hunker down and kind of push it. So let's just treat it like there's handles to the inside that they got going that they can bend over and are relatively shielded from.
Mom's here. Mom's here.
And that sounds like Asphodel.
Mom's here.
Mom's here.
It's Mom. Mom's here. Mom. Mom's here. It's supposed to be.
All right. So I think you guys have had enough time to catch up to the 350 mark. I'm going to go ahead and start Hot Ones now.
Experience and puts it right into the page and right into the map. And it's just, it's refreshing to see it not look very.
Here.
You're not really hurt. Vin, if you could help clear some of that stuff. No. Down. You know better. No.
It didn't mean.
There's food down.
My dog.
That doesn't matter.
I hurt him. Stop.
He wasn't
My
hurt.
My package did not arrive Thursday, November.
We'll be right back. And we're back. We've got some sushi being consumed. And we're going to hop into Mario Batali.
Whoa. The rat food crossover. This one of my favorite exploded explodes. In recent years, so I want you to think about a hypothetical, okay?
Right, so we're moving back to our bugbear. We've got the alternate for them, which is this war sled. But what is their actual standard? If they're going to be the melee guys, they also need some sort of, like, ranged capability. And I think what might be fun is some sort of like, not really bucket attack, but like cask attack, or like I see them carrying around like some sort of bucket or shovel worth of something. So let's do just your regular barrel. How are we going to do that is we're going to draw a circle up top. And then we're going to bevel it out and bring it back down. Bevel it out and bring it back down. Get a couple of lines down at the bottom and connect that. Alright. So let's get to right there. Now let's add some of that ribbing. We have one thin wire in the middle with another one. But these are going to be thin, so make some lines on them. And we've got the actual wood of the cask. I'm going to bring that forward. Very cool right here. Bring that in. Bring that in. Yeah, I saw the episode where he made that. It looked very good. A little bit of filler. Now let's put a couple of like bad smell vapor style notations kind of coming off what's in the barrel, and then attach it. So now let's put probably like a couple of handles, and we'll put one on either side. Right like that. And we'll put another one. These would be pretty crude, probably just hammered in and sealed with maybe a pine tar, just so they could grab it and shuck it or throw it. So there'd be some sort of like massive AoE combustible.
Sounds dangerous.
That it is, my friend.
Booming success.
So what will they have as regular weapons? I want to give them something from Battlefield 1, I think. So let's give them the billhook.
I'm so
bring his forearm up to the side. Kind of get that thumb. Yeah, we'll have the chest kind of right there. His thumb creases. And the bill hook is a really thick blade, and then it comes forward. So bring that forward, and then bring that up to a tearing point. Yeah. Just like that. Something to kind of hook in and then rip, and maybe be able to play with some grapple abilities. Or something like that. Let's put a couple of those banded wraps around the wrist as well. Running along this arm.
Marco Pierre White was a super talented chef. He was very hard to work for. And fundamentally, because most chefs, when they end up screaming at you, it's because deep in their heart, they know they didn't treat you right.
What do you think is like the closest you were ever to being broken at that time in your life?
I was.
All right, so we've got kind of set up here. Let's throw those banded arm coverings over here as well. All right, so we got our bugbears. They are now on the Hot Ones Fire Reach Chipotle.
Yeah, you make this. We make this.
What's in it?
So it's a Chipotle base, and then we undercut it with a citrus blend.
That actually sounds good.
I couldn't handle it. I was done at the second one.
Yeah, like I can't do spicy food that well, but it actually sounds kind of good.
It sounds delicious.
Spicy crab and spicy mayo.
All right, Mario, so a recurring segment.
I was crying in my Thai food earlier, and it was a 3 out of 5.
I was watching my dad eating some really hot wings as a kid, and I remember looking over, and he was just profusely sweating because they were, like, so hot, because he got the ones drenched in sweat.
So again, there is no Billy. To recap the room, we've got Bashanye, Asel, then the Wisp, and Chooth. And we're back.
Yeah, see, Kanye is his shooting guy.
Tanya got up to speak, and there was a bet on the over and under. Everyone was told to speak 3 to 4 minutes. My wife made the bet on 9.5 minutes over, and won the table raffle. He went for 10-20, and she took like $400 home off the center of the table. Everyone was throwing in 20s just to get to the bet. I had him under 3 minutes.
Was it a rousing speech? Do you remember?
Yeah, you know, it was like Kanye in general, controversial. Chiaro scudo, flying. How's that?
You, Paul McCartney, Questlove? What's going on?
My birthday. Me and Jimmy Fallon share a birthday. Nancy, his wife, called me about 6 months ago and said, listen, we're going to get some tickets to this show on your birthday. What are you doing?
Oh, yeah. I saw that episode.
Let's go. So we went to dinner and remember the show. Paul, of course, near the end of the show, breaks out of his head.
I feel bad for Jimmy. Like, it sucks about his mom.
I hadn't met him.
Did you see the Taylor Swift?
Paul made a cake appearance
So Taylor Swift is in the bad person. She's not like creepy, like incestuous, but just like, when he was living away, she like, well, your hand right now, you know, like, she's in that physical, like, to comfort. So whenever they were, do you remember how Taylor Swift, Paul, or like, when he was at her bedside while she was dying, she was out of emission for a stand until Taylor Swift knew so many years day, talks about in the back of the taxi, grabbing her hand, and she's saying on the show for him, and then burst into tears. That's nice. My plastic bad blood, my little. So Taylor Swift isn't a bad person. I mean, she has done good things.
We all have Calvin Harris crew for life.
Calvin
Harris crew.
Okay, so Swiss hearts.
This is my favorite part because that like they start really just start going at it.
So there are a few things that we love here at First Meet.
I figured out how I keep fucking up this pattern, guys. I know that you guys aren't that focused on this.
In starting with this hobgoblin, I've kind of given him a spikier hairstyle, and I've drawn his face to be just a little more humanoid. But not by much. But like I said, these are going to be our caster derivatives. And so we're probably going to be looking at warlocks and clerics.
What is it in Mario Batali's head that when you see something on Twitter, you decide, you know what? I have time today.
I have the time today, basically. That's it.
I think one of my favorite episodes is like him talking with Key and Peele.
Yeah. That was a pretty good episode of Hot Ones. How do we want to present their bodies? You know, can it get any grosser than the scalp armor? Let's think more about what it means to be dominated and have this kind of like element of domination. Think a lot less armor and think a lot more like Opus Dei, some sort of like self-penance marker that's really masochistic. So I think scarations, I think piercings, I think something like that, but mostly nude, except for these fetishes embedded in their skin. So the first thing I think of is maybe like leather coiling of like a whip.
Bring it across. You're in the edge of my wheelhouse.
So, from the days of
bring this kind of chest forward. We have a nipple here, and let's pierce that. Bring that across. And maybe it's got some sort of like charm on it to boost off of the blood. So it's maybe put like a nail that's always just kind of like dripping out of these nipples.
The fresh noodles fit some dishes, but as a whole, most of the time.
Going down. Make it really grotesque.
Mozzarella.
You go all
the way to Bufala, and then you go mozzarella to impress you. So I nailed the Bufala,
right?
And then I pat myself on the back, the let my guard down, and then my disgusting Midwest control just came.
Oh, no.
I don't think you're allowed up here, Douglas.
No, sir. No, sir.
We're going to make some of these lines a little more contrasting.
Sir.
To help draw some of the emphasis onto his face where we need it to be. Let's do the same with this eyelid up here. Yeah, they'd have scraggly eyebrows. Nothing beautiful, something very strange. Let's do the same with the under the nose.
No, he's being with his hands, because he's a New Yorker.
Okay. So it comes down, we have these nipple piercings down into his actual body. And we're dealing with this kind of nudity. Let's get some definition.
1,000.
What does that mean? How hot it is?
The Scoville rating.
Yeah. Where is that? That's pretty high.
Yeah.
Here.
Their first sauce was Valencio. They start off at like tamale sauce. And that usually ranks in around like 1,500 to 3,000.
What's the highest?
It's the one they have at the end, and they tell you what the highest one is. I can't remember off the top of my head. I think it's 25,000.
Yeah, I think it's a quarter of a mil.
I just laugh so much to the back.
Quarter of a...
So, I know that you're a music obsessive, and many credit you at the forefront of this movement to bring playlists to the dining room. Can't hear you. Wow.
Yeah, that's about the way I respond every time they do this stuff. So I'm going to add in some scarration instead of any deliberate tattooing, so we're just going to do a couple of bilateral marks that run parallel, and then we're going
to
do these kind of wavy ones that go across it. Yeah, so we have this heavy scarration on the body. We want to make everything look like a whoa. What the fuck happened to this guy? Maybe he was burned by some sort of magical acid.
Magacin. Magacin.
So if that's their normal build, what should their alternate build be? Well, like I said, I think this would be the like priest derivative.
Wow.
550,000. Okay. So maybe you're right. Maybe it is 1 million.
I said quarter of a million, but I was wrong.
Yeah, I know. I said it's in the millions.
That's as much as I recommend you eat, ladies and gentlemen. Just
Liquid.
I'm not afraid of Rachel Ray. Bring her on. I'm going to keep it with that cat and that
pony. Callan, when he bailed. I love that Ricky Gervais episode. Oh, he bitched out?
No, he actually goes, but he actually eats it.
Something looking funny on me?
No.
Oh, you look great. Something looking funny on me? We both have
to. I think he still eats it.
Oh my gosh. Well, if he does, that's crazy. So now we need to add in this warlock derivative. So what would they have? Well, we know that Belloc is somehow related to the Unseelie, so... Probably looking at something in the realm of the Archfey build, but kind of distort those powers to your choosing. Cheers. Was I supposed to eat it?
Credit?
That's from Asphodel.
And then, too, you know, you caused a little bit of a kerfuffle in the pot community when you shared your recipe.
You're just like
against
you. You're not
lovely crabbing.
Okay, yeah, I was right. It was in the tomb.
So this is the last dab. We call it the call it the last dab because it's tradition around here.
Two
to put a little extra
million.
On the last wing.
What's the Reaper at?
Gnome? I watch this show for entertainment. I don't watch it like, ooh, I want to get that.
No,
I'm just like, oh, this is neat.
It just sounds like my fucking nightmare.
It is. Most definitely. Maybe let's
do
a symbol of like power. So I'm going to do some kind of like flare.
Happy Thanksgiving.
And then I'm going to add that tree in there. Oh, wait, not a tree.
All right, Mario, so what a Thanksgiving
dark, jet black
Valentina
stone.
First
oh, wow.
To the Queen Majesty.
The Carolina Reaper is
so
actually
much.
Weaker than that one.
Topping things off with a big glob of the last dab that you were able to maneuver around like a pocket.
Carolina Reaper is 1.5 million.
Get you out of here. I have one more question for you, Mario Vitali. It's time to settle some age-old Thanksgiving debates, okay? Breast or thigh?
Traditionally, the bird tends to be a little overcooked in the breast because everyone's
yes.
following the USDA thing and they're trying to take it to 170. 170 is
wrong. 170? That's too hot.
White wine or red wine?
For me?
Red.
Mm-hmm. I start with the white and I finish with the red.
There you go. Pumpkin pie or apple pie?
Apple.
I don't really understand pumpkin pie spices across the board, let alone in my kimchi.
The Giants or the Redskins?
So we get that, Jim.
You heard it here first. Mario Vitali on Thanksgiving special hot ones, licking wings, and giving NFL pick-ems. Now, Mario, there's nothing left to do but go off the red carpet. Happy Thanksgiving to the hot one fans out there. This camera, this camera, this camera. Let the people know what you have going on.
So that's the alternate build.
Anyone
want to make me so? Good. Yes. Yes. No. Merci. Yes. It's got some kind of like
loincloth
in there.
Oh, my goats on balloons.
You're flying goats.
Okay. All right, so.
I'm going to go shower.
Sean Evans checking
nice.
In with a very her special
root.
Nice.
So now let's get our
I feel like they shouldn't be soiled. You know what I'm doing?
This is our hobgoblin.
Sauces that might be featured on future seasons of Hot
Ones,
and then some very
all right.
special
yeah.
for making my night.
You're welcome.
We got,
sorry
to
put you guys through the ringer.
We got Ben here.
I almost killed Ross. Armin just killed Ross and
Isabel. You mean Edwin?
No, Ross. Because his name is still Ross in the game.
For more information and to order,
okay, so Edwin.
I see what you're saying.
I see what you're saying, but like his name in the game.
I get it.
More information and to order
because he still hasn't picked a character name.
Anonymity.
His character name, that's what his character name is. He's
okay, so we've got our goblins laid out. We've got our goblin, our bugbear, and our hobgoblin. It's trying to get started on the next episode, but we had already selected Sirens of the Realms. So I'm going to go ahead and post this one. If you haven't seen any of the Dungeons & Dragons programming on YouTube, it's fucking fantastic.
Before we do that,
I'll also take this moment to plug our Patreon, which I actually don't have to look up. Donate to us if you want to keep us going via either Twitch. We have the Stream Elements donation page set up on the actual channel page. Or if you want to be a subscriber, we're trying to get our first 5 subscribers on Patreon in order to release the maps for the Sunless Citadel. And you can find us
Sunless
at...
Citadel.
What?
I said the Sunless Shit-a-del. And then I tried to frat snap and it didn't work out for me.
Are you talking to shit Adele?
Yeah.
That's not very nice to say that about the singer.
No.
So I'm definitely talking about Ruins of Adventure on Patreon, and these maps, despite feedback, are actually very beautiful and they do not look like shit.
No, I wasn't saying that the maps
they look
like shit. I was saying
glorious.
I was saying that the people, the enemies that we're gonna have to fight in the second, in the whatever Sunless Citadel, ain't shit. That's what I'm trying to say. You know?
My anime gesture gets across. Check us out on Patreon. It's there in the comments. Love to see ya. And anyway, we're going to start with Sirens of the Realms. So Sirens of the Realms is by Dungeons & Dragons. It's one of the Maze Arcana programs. And it's DM'd by Satine Phoenix. It looks like they have a couple other...
Satine. She cute.
It's a women-only group. And they play with two cameras split up on either side of a long table. What a luxury. And they have some pretty cool sponsors. They've got Black Magic Design for their cameras. They've got Sirenscape for their something, and they got Wormwood boxes, and they have new rules that I think I might actually instill into my game.
Like,
if you drop a die, like you roll it off the table, you have to re-roll it with disadvantage.
Billy, that is not fair. That is not fair. Physics exists. I disagree with that. 100%.
It's all about control, but it applies to the Dungeon Master as well.
I disagree.
So we shall see.
I 100% disagree with that.
But while we have this inked, we have some others we need to do. So if you linted your masking tape when you were putting it up on your drawing board, you should have no problem lightly peeling this off. You're more than welcome to stand. They can't see you.
I can't stand for this.
Right, so we're going to take our goblins off.
I like that.
Yeah, we'll pass it around.
Goblins.
It's a bunch of moblins.
Have you seen Gravity Falls?
No.
Has anyone out there seen Gravity Falls?
It's on Hulu Plus.
That's where I've seen it. Like, I've seen, like, the little thing. I just got done watching Runaways.
Gotcha. It's very fun. I think you would really like it.
I thought they just dropped one episode.
No, they dropped three episodes.
Oh. Newsflash.
Every episode's on Thursday, so I think actually they have a new one out.
I made the foolish decision to only watch that with Asphodel, so I'll catch up after regular running.
I think I have to finish the third episode, but like I mainly watched it because I saw James Marsters was in it, so I really like him as an actor.
What else has he been in?
He was in Torchwood. He was Spike in Buffy. He does the Dresden Files audiobooks as well. That's what I mainly know him from.
Three strikes. None of you guys could see me, but I was just shaking my head.
All right, so we're going to start with our bosses. And because of that, I will be describing them very vaguely.
I'm going to head home, though.
Okay, Ben's out.
By the way, I'll let you out.
If you want to do BF1 tonight, I'm down for it.
Okay.
Buffin.
Should we put some BF1 on?
Hold on.
Should we do some video?
Yeah, and I'll come back for my cross stitch. Or not my cross stitch, my clothing situation. Oh my god.
Alright, let's go. I'm ready. Alright, so starting some Sirens of the Realms. Well, if they're not gonna be here, I'll still start.
And you see this large, it looks like an island. Just moving fast past you, and you see a ship in the distance, and this big creature and all these sharks.
What I've noticed in DMing styles in terms of like the difference between me and others is I prefer to articulate the details based on what people can relate in their own world rather than using automatopoeia or doing any voice acting like that. But people on this one go the opposite direction with it, and I mean it works. I just,
you guys are going by.
It's not for me. But anyway, so we got three people we really got to draw. We've got to do Belloc, and then we got to do the two other, the two siblings of Carowyn, Tallwyn and Shar or something. Sharwin, I think. We'll get them in here, and I may include one other. I'm thinking some kind of good hobgoblin. But we can at least start with them. And they came with templates in the book if you don't want to draw them. But I always think it's fun to do my kind of interpretation. So we'll do Belloc in the middle. And from what I can tell, he wears a cloak pretty much all the time. So you're just going to bring this kind of fold out to here, and then we're going to bring out this beard that just kind of pings at an across pattern, and he seemed to have very piercing eyes, so I'm just going to kind of flesh out this beard a little bit more.
So in a way, yes, we are
immune. And just kind of help understand his mouth a little bit more. As the mustache brings down and up, we would see that bottom lip. And then these eyes were super piercing. And he has them like raised. And then everything else is kind of dark. So let's just get these crazy big eyes. And then just kind of bring in that darkness all around.
I'm buddy in the mind.
No, I think that is a good acknowledgement. If we do sail past this turtle,
yeah,
we will have to play a toll, perhaps.
Turtle?
Yeah. Bring that beard out.
I like to imagine that, like, if you see you're on the screen,
yeah, very much like that. Now let's close off portion beside his face. Just like that.
There's a lot of seagulls in this.
Yeah, it's kind of like angry eye that's bent and coming down.
Most of you can imagine a half spread, a 5 foot tall half spread half
elf. Green eye.
Yeah, and I'll bring that out. Kind of.
And a tall and luxuriously lanky star elf. Why don't you explain what
it is? As it brings down onto the bottom of the spear, you're going to want to kind of accentuate light coming off of it.
Human body person, even though the way of it,
yeah. And I know he has a staff, for sure. Where we kind of want to put it, I see him kind of like holding on to it at his waist, you know, kind of with both hands going side to side. But we could also do it maybe out in one arm, really strong.
Your monk-like ninja skills, you got this. And
I may actually just leave it all together, since we already have that kind of like imagery from the book to already work with. I am gonna add this back to it.
I have chunks of my stomach inside.
Yeah.
In my hair.
I
know. Just because you're so much shorter than me doesn't mean I can't see you.
Brought it up.
Thank you.
Nothing above the waist. I'm feeling left out.
Can I bring this down?
Off the side of the show.
See, maybe.
Do not wish to have.
Are you pretending or are you trying?
I'm really trying to.
How are you?
I believe in you. I can do it.
Maybe it's holding it from behind. To where it's kind of like coming up. Right behind the head, and it's all gnarled.
I
didn't
even try that before. So why don't you do a sleight of hand?
Yeah. And then maybe this other hand is producing some sort of magic.
Fantastic. Wow.
Success.
Use my finger, you say? Yes, I am one of you.
But it's like the cleanest vomit you've ever seen. It's just like, it just in a very stream.
Kind
like
of pointing down and radiating something.
Makes its way into a pot and a plant.
And then we'll kind of fill in the other two to either side.
I see what you mean. A very unpleasant experience.
Just when I hated everything about this situation.
Bring it up to here. Get up to the side. Add some of these knuckles.
Bathe and clean and smell better than this.
Yes, Vanya did say say we had accommodations prepared for us. Is she here with us?
She's not.
Gotta give out these fingers. As they're doing whatever they're doing.
She's a companion that I appreciate. Ah, good. Because I have written it. What is it? In my mind.
We'll say that this is coming off of that particular hand to kind of reveal.
We are going to go to Kai's house.
Yeah, when you have your hand out like that and you're kind of just doing that, you're not really going to see much of the pinky.
Memory is very old. I'm very old. I forget things and it goes backwards. But we have to go to see Kaya. Ah, Kaya's house of repose. Off we go. Now, please.
You want a letter from Vanya?
Yes.
Just like that.
To me. Addressed to me. My mouth was busy performing activities of the external.
Kind of coming out.
Just throwing up. Not able to talk at all. But now that we are here,
bring that chest line up. Let this kind of cloak come down. And
there's a couple of other things that we have to do, but I cannot say another word until I stop reeking of dead
and get
fish.
These across. He is pretty solidly armored and built in terms of an NPC. I saw that he had some kind of like fur lining kind of coming down just right like that. And he had some sort of like leather strips.
And just bustling with people.
Good night, stream.
Night, stream.
Benny.
You're leaving it?
Yeah, I'm gonna go quilt to my bed so I can take off my pants.
Word. We'll be right back. Gotta go to a standby. And I'm back. Well, it looks like the camera kind of got jilted earlier. Didn't realize that.
Me too. Are they going to wear it tomorrow?
All right, yeah, so we're...
And
There we go. We got our main homie going here. What? Let's keep on working on him.
Yeah. I mean, I'll
let's draw these stitches right here. Let's get some fur kind of going on either side. No, just like that. Keep drawing this contrast. So it kind of like drapes down.
I'm going to wear C&D on Sunday. I bought it specifically to be long enough for work. I may pin it before I leave for work in the morning. It's like an inch and a half cleavage. It's just that it's like tight. Does that make sense?
It does. As these robes would kind of fall down and off a little bit. Really just gonna bring that up on that inside margin. Yeah, just like right like that. And then real deep on that inside. Yeah, perfect. Bring up on that black. I think he has another bit of fur that it kind of ends with right here as it comes to that portion, and I think he has them cross-patched, just like leather squares. So I'm adding in some lines, and then I'm going to bring that kind of fur across to this other side and continue adding these lines. Give him these stitch marks all the way across. Consistency. So there we go. It's darkness in the middle. This darkness underneath. Blam. Just bringing that staff down. Bring that staff up. It's got these gnarly looking protrusions that come out and off the wood. And a couple of them are forward in the view, so I'll let those kind of do heavy lifting and make everything else black. Yeah, just like that. Boom. Very gnarly looking. He's giving off a little magical power. And we can make that colored if we want to later. Let's go ahead and add in some of this contrast from the beard. And then some of the contrast just for, you know, the space. So I'm going to bring that value in off the corner there. Definitely going to accent that value. Bring it down. I'm going to bring it off the corner here as well, but much less so because, you know, be able to see quite a bit more, and then I'm going to come right there. Okay, so boom. You can definitely tell that he's in a 3D space. And that's what's important about the whole thing. I'm going to do it over here just a little bit. Just a little bit. Bring it. Yeah. Very good. You know, that kind of magical power is influencing the light. We'll definitely make sure to cover that when we get into our color. Let's see what we got on the chat. Anyone out there? Uh-oh, come back. Going up there. Going once, going twice. Do this for another 16 minutes. I don't really feel like doing Sirens of the Realms. Can put on some more of the tunes. More of the tunes. I could go for some country, to be honest. But I don't think anybody else could, so I'll settle for compromise. I've been thinking about my boy Tom Petty. I could go for some Tom Petty. I could also go for some Johnny Nash. Stir it up. Alright, so now we gotta get our other two guys, one of which is very proud of a sword. So I kinda like see him standing with it, hand kinda like across the body, kinda hanging on that left side. So we'll probably have to start his body just a little bit lower. I'll do a shoulder line here, bring it in. Like that. They kind of bring this down and forward. Yeah. Right like that. Now I see like a hand guard. And up like that. And the blade is lightly curved back. And I believe it's pretty nastily serrated like that. Yeah, and then let's do a kind of hazy bloodline. Yeah, it kind of goes up like that. Let's bring these shoulders in to meet the neck. Kind of like that. You'd probably be looking on, you know, right here. Come up, cut the face in half. This is probably a collar. This is probably the neck. Right like that. Bringing it down. Probably have just a little bit of an armor attachment right there. Bring that across, add some of those rivets. People know that that's metal. Perfect. I want to do the same over here as it kind of comes down and around. Just accent these kind of portions. Allow for some of that high value contrast to kind of set in. Nice little patina there. As that doublet kind of comes down, you can have this area be tied off. So we probably have some bunching going on there. Elbow, good strong forcep. And once we get to the hand, I see some sort of like corded bracelet. And then be careful with your hand when you're doing stuff like this. So I see hand wraps. Let's make these knuckle marks, kind of bring these fingers out just a little bit. But let's get some of these wraps kind of going around. A little bit of texture, yeah. Bring that doublet down here, cinch it with a nice girdle. Yeah, that doublet would continue on. I believe he has relatively long hair. I think definitely kind of drifts apart here across the face. Yeah, kind of a furrowed brow, like an angry dude. We'll skip Marvin Gaye. Anybody out there? Still no one. Sad. One day I'll have chat streamers and or streaming or chat while I'm streaming. It'll be nice. Alright. I could do some little red Corvette. Hair kind of comes out a little bit. I think he has a stylish mustache. Yeah, and then let's close him with that sword. Bring this back up. Complete. Connect. Just like we had on the other side, and draw that contrast. I don't think we'd see maybe some of the hair. But you wouldn't see any of the face. There wouldn't really be a whole lot on here in terms of a hilt, but we could maybe see some sort of pouch that he has hanging off here. Give him some of those options. Button clasp out there. Maybe he's got something up his sleeve too. And then kind of just draw in this dark area outside of the magic. Alright, and so then we need to get the next one. I'm gonna add some arm hair here. And I'm gonna add some folds up in this. Right like that. And as for this girdle, go ahead and have it be plated with metal. Just like that. Alright, so we got the girdle going on, nice and strong. Now we have the last of the bosses. Got 10 minutes. And I definitely know that she is a caster, so I'm gonna get him looking dead on, him looking dead on, she'll be looking dead on as well. So let's make kind of this shape for her face. Bring these ears up and out. Just a really soft feature on that chin. And then if she had a hairline right here, she'd probably attach that up. Down for sure. Okay, I get that neck. Since it is a woman, you're gonna want to go thinner. Since this is kind of down to the side, bring this up, connect that hairline. This one's probably wheeled back. Same as this bit, but this one probably has a lot longer to accomplish those kinds of goals. And even with it done back, we could probably see just a bit of residual hair right here on the back. Beautiful. And a much softer nose than what he has. And then she wouldn't really wear that bit of armor, but she would still have that doublet. So draw the shoulders to be a little bit softer, and we're gonna clasp this. That was the breast. Okay. And then we'll get up here and kind of focus on this brow real quick. And it looks like my tape's come off, so just reset it. It's okay. It happens. It's not a big deal. Ooh man, I gotta love some 38 special. So let's get these eyebrows in. So you get these eyes. Soft nose. Okay. And why is she smiling? And we kind of need to adjust these brows. She's smiling because she... Let's go with a kind of a chord. And we'll wreath her in flame, except for her hands. Let's put them like shooting down to her sides. So you know, if the shoulder was right here, we go down to like right here. Let's see. Yeah, some hands. Spread fingers. Just jets of flame shooting right up in between. Same with right there. Just keep that going. Yeah. Beautiful. We'll just color those fingers black, just leaving really her crested in these flames. Bring them up off her shoulders a little bit. Just kind of add this value to show that they're wrapping off something 3D. Yeah, now let's get some of that threading known. Yeah, I like that. Just like he did, some of those folds. Kinda messed up the face a little bit, so I've got to go in, tighten it up just a little bit. Yeah. All right, so there we go. We've got our villains, or at least we've got the line work done for them. And we'll pick up with coloring them. This is a good place to start. We can make these flames any color we want. They don't actually have to be red. I'm thinking more on the green. And I'll put a little symbol here of like a black tree. Very cool. Well, all right. Thanks for joining tonight. I'm going to go ahead and hop out, but I hope you enjoy the new Bob Ross setup, and this is how I'll be doing it from now on so that you guys can see my face and see me do it the whole time. Really appreciate it if you joined in, and next time don't be afraid to chat. I will see you guys later. Peace.